Hey guys, this is Ravindra. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk about budget stay whenever I travel within India and outside of India. If you're into traveling and if you're a backpacker like me, then there are multiple ways to save money, and I'll be sharing all of those tips in this video. So before I go any further, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hit on that bell icon to get all the latest updates. I'll be sharing a lot of videos in the coming days. When it comes to traveling, there are three important expenses that you will have to think about. One is the travel expense, other one is the food, and the third is the stay. So in this video, I'm going to cover more of where you can stay, how you can stay in budget hotels and hostels. Today, I'm going to talk about youth hostels in India, its membership, and how you can use this card even outside of India. Well, there are various benefits that you get out of this membership, and it can be used worldwide for a discounted stay in most of the hostels around the world. Well, I have attended multiple adventure programs organized by the Youth Hostel Association of India. Well, the first one being the Goa trekking, which was for 10 days, and believe it or not, the cost was just around 3,990. That too during New Year time, which includes food, tent stay, insurance, guide charges, forest entry, and everything. Same is the case when I did Leh mountain biking expedition, which was around 7,000 to 8,000 rupees for about 7 days, including the rental for the mountain bike. When it comes to membership, you can either go for 1 year, 2 year, or even lifetime membership. And this membership won't cost you much. I got my membership long back, and the price was around 1,500 to 1,700, including shipment charges. Well, the lifetime membership of hostels is around 2,500, I guess, as of now. You can check the description below where I've shared the link of their website by haindia.org. The best thing about membership is that you can take part in all the adventure programs within that country, wherever you are. If you're in India, then you can take part in all of the programs that are organized by them here in India for a very less price. The adventure programs include trekking, mountain biking, sailing, and many more programs. They even have family events. Recently, I had stayed in these hostels when I traveled to California. It was a week-long stay, and I stayed in two different hostels. It was an ideal stay. It was more of a bunker, and also they even have family rooms. They have all the facilities that you need, and also they provide you with all the information that you want to travel around. The best thing about these hostels is that you get to meet like-minded people, which is really, really good. One best thing about this program is all those people whomever I spoke to date, they are still very good friends of mine, and we keep sharing all our travel stories all the time, even though it has been so many years now. If you want to attend any of the adventure programs here in India, then you can check out the link below, yhaindia.org, where they have mentioned all the state-wise and national adventure programs. If you're from some other country, then I'm sure the hostels in your country will have their own programs which you can attend. The best thing is with this membership card, you can travel around the world. They have hostels, whether it's Japan, Europe, US, India, or wherever it is, you can stay in these hostels for a much lesser price. As of this recording, if you were to stay in a hotel, then it would easily cost you at least $120 to $200 a day. Whereas if you stay in a youth hostel, it would hardly cost you $20 to $30 in the US. Whereas in India or in Asian countries, it is as low as $2 to $5. So consider staying here. If you're in India, then you might want to visit the International Youth Hostels, because those are real good hostels. None of these are sponsored. I've been to this place, and I've seen many of the trekkers and backpackers staying in these hostels, which is a much better option than staying in hotels at times. Because as a backpacker or as a traveler, you will be traveling all the time, and you don't want to spend too much of your time in a hotel. So all that you need is a place to sleep. So I would highly recommend you to go and get the membership of Youth Hostel or the HiHostel, whichever hostel is available in your country, because it's worth it, and it won't cost you a big amount. and the membership is a lifetime membership. So consider it, because I've been a member, all my family members are members of it, and it's a good one. And there is no age limit here in India, whereas I guess there is age limit in other countries, but in India there is no age limit as of this recording. So go ahead, you can check the website, apply for membership. I think within 15 or 20 days you'll get your membership card, or you can even go to any of the hostel and become a member then and there. I've been a member and I've made use of it, and I want to attend more of their programs. It is good. So guys, much more than any other hotel, I wanted to speak about the hostels. I keep getting this question all the time, so I thought of making this video and share this information. I guess this is useful. I'm glad that I could share this information if you were not aware of it. So if you think that this information was useful, then go ahead, subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit on that bell icon. I'll be sharing many more information of this kind. So leave a comment if you have any queries, and hit that like button.